Hello. Let's now talk about how you can enable and test Azure AD Application Proxy. To do this, there are five main steps. First, you'll need to download and register the connector, that lightweight on-premises agent. Then you'll need to configure each application in the Azure portal. Third, you'll want to configure any single sign-on that the application may need. Fourth, you'll need to assign a user. And fifth, you can test the application. Let's take a look at how you would do each of these steps. So in order to configure Application Proxy, you'll need to be in the Azure portal. When you go to the Azure portal, make sure that you've gone to Azure Active Directory. Now the first step was to download and register a connector. The way you do that is by going to the Application Proxy menu. Now from here, you'll be able to manage all of your connectors, which includes download the connector. So you can click on that. Once you accept the terms, then you'll be prompted to download the connector and run that. Now when you click Run, you will see this installer here. You can agree to the terms and conditions and click Install. You will also be asked to authenticate as a global administrator to make sure that only global admins are allowing this access to on-premises resources. Once the connector registration is complete and the installation is complete, you will see the connector appear here in the menus below. Step two was to create the application in the Azure portal. So to do that, we'll now go over to Enterprise Applications. Once here, you'll go to the top, click New Application. And in this case, we're looking to add an on-premises application, so you'll select the middle icon. From here, you'll go through and fill out some basic information about your application, what you want the name to be, the internal URL, which is the intranet site that a user would use to get to the application when on the company network, the external URL that you want to provide for them, and then a few other configurations. Once you've filled that out, so I'm just going to slide over here, you can go ahead and click Add. Once you click Add, this application will be added to the portal, and you will next be able to come and configure additional settings. So you will come into this application-specific menu after you click Add, and from here, you'll want to go to Single Sign-On. This is where you can configure any sign-on depending on the authentication method expected by your back-end application. There are many different options here, and depending on the one you select, you will get different fields here to help with the authentication process. Step four was to assign users to the application. So you'll need to go to the Users and Group menu, from which you can click an Add User and go ahead and add additional users to the application. The single sign-on and users process is the same as what you will have seen for any other applications in the Azure portal. Now finally, once you've done all of that, you can go ahead and test the application. There are two ways you can do that. One of them is through the Access Panel. When you're here, you will see Application Proxy apps listed the same way as other applications, and all you need to do from here is to click on it. What you can also do is to navigate directly to the external application URL that you configured when publishing the app. With these five steps, you have now deployed your Application Proxy applications, and you've also done some basic tests. In the next video, we'll learn more about how to actually deploy this completely and additional considerations as you move this into production.